Well, right now I've been responding to comments. Look at these comments. These idiots like to try to attack folks who are schizophrenic because they don't have a soul. That's how you always know it's not a person. So the goal is to try to find out what lie they're telling themselves to get through the day. Because everything soulless is always telling themselves a lie. It's like a lot of them become Christians that just have a go-to lie, like a ready-made lie to tell themselves that, yeah, my mistakes don't count. Mercy! Which doesn't make sense. It's not in the Bible. None of that makes sense. Where the Bible says, you know, you have to be right, and those who think ahead and those who don't make mistakes are better. And then you can ask them what constitutes a mistake, and they would never know because they're really not people. So they would point to things that don't even affect anyone else or things that aren't impactful. It's just like a baby trying to figure out what their parents are doing when they're having sex. Where it's just off the wall stuff that don't even make sense. They're saying, yeah, someone who's gay, you sin. It's like, no, it would have to be some effect to someone else. It's the same reason rape is bad. It would have to be some effect to someone else. These idiots really can't tell the difference between consensual sex and rape. They can't tell the difference. Yeah, you can find a soulless thing and you can tell them. You could just brainwash them and say, hey, someone having sex is bad. And then it would just all mush together. They can't tell if it's rape or anything. They can't see shades of gray. They can't see in between stuff. They have what I call all or nothing brains. So one thing that they're doing, they're walking around with a lie that if they're trying, then that's all that counts. And then someone can correct them from their mistakes. And because they're trainable, that means they're not evil. that's all it means. that's the only lie. And it's a very easy lie to tear down, basically. So it's a lot of things you can do. It's a lot of things you can do. You can say something like this. You have to insult, like if they call someone schizophrenic or something, you don't worry about yourself. You just point it out to and focus their brain, a Clockwork Orange style. And you say so, like you have to insult all schizophrenic people to feel like you're on the higher rung of a pack system. Dogs think like that. No real person is ever that low. and then what I do, I make these idiots perfect enraged beasts, so they can go out and test who's gonna still be their friend. So whoever stays their friend can go to hell. But so then you can say some other stuff, and it's going to overwhelm their soulless brain. But that still, that pinch that made them have to respond is still going to be there when you overwhelm their brain. And say some other stuff, so then they would just get more mindless and more aggressive and run in circles more. So then this idiot was already defeated. And so now he thinks he has a friend. Every soulless thing has a broken mindset where they have a mindless need to join because they're incomplete. And they think joining someone else is going to instantly make them more credible. So they have to look for similarities. They have to look for similarities to basically bond with others, which in itself means someone doesn't have a soul. If you have to look for someone with similarities, like it's like, it's like you're black, and then you say, well, they're black, so that's an opening. Or if you just can't have an opening based on things that aren't visual or aren't similarities, where you're looking inside yourself and then going outward, that means you're not a person when you have to do that. You're basically reverse engineering shit to look like you have a diverse mindset, but you don't. You're just a dumb soulless thing. So anyone who ever does that, you can always know they're soulless, and you can go practice on them. You can go trigger them for whatever, so they won't bother people in the future. You could do a lot of stuff to earn your way to heaven on that. Right now, right now I'm pretty much OP. So you tell the idiot this, but then you tell him some more stuff too, and it just makes them. It's like hitting a beehive, where anyone who stays their friend is being tested by them having no positive goals, by them being more and more salty. Then you're tested to basically instantly to send yourself to hell because you can't find, you won't even be able to formulate anything good. You would be able to say maybe they can get right later or I didn't see something, but then you're already seeing it. So it makes them perfect testers. So here's the first comment. Again, with the goal of not getting this thing to instantly go and off itself, but to make it a perfect traffic light where it can send someone to heaven or hell, because it's not a person. If you're still trying to haggle in your brain if it's a person or if you still need more proof, that means you're not a person. That's all it means. That's all it means. So you say something like you're fixating on something. I call it having a false goal. You're fixating on something. I call that having a false goal. That happens when your brain gives up on you. Let me prove it. So if I'm schizophrenic, how does that help you? You just proved you have a brain that mushes everything together. One thing wrong about me makes everything right about you. One thing wrong makes everything wrong. You just proved on your own you can't think on that level. You're trying to display pride over not being able to read a lot of words. You know you're broken because you bond with others by looking for similarities. and then this idiot says, "Does your family think you're a nut job?" While I was asleep or whatever. So then, and then this idiot. And then, but this idiot, I'm going to focus on this. This idiot was cornered and his brain is messed up. Now it has to find a way to look strong, but then it knows it's too weak to challenge anything I'm saying. So you have to say it's a joke, but then he has to get a backhanded insult in. When you see that, that only happens with soulless life. And a lot of people get confused by it. It's basically them having an internal struggle where they're so worthless. They're internally struggling inside of them. But then they're a mindless animal who have to feel like they're not on the bottom rung of the pack. So that's why that happens, where it's an insult at the end. So here's the first response. Where, again, I'm an expert on this, so I know exactly what tone to create. To create more depression from this response. So it's like you operate on the level of a baby and have deluded yourself that your words and actions are harmless, which is what they're doing too, because they're thinking little old me can't hurt anything because they have a baby brain. So then you have to make sure you point out the truth and say real people are never that broken, because they're walking around with a lie to basically say they're a real person. So you got to say real people are never that broken. You got to put it on their brain. They can't think. Here's how you know you're not a person too. If you're thinking, if you don't understand that these things have no ability to independently learn, copycatting isn't learning. Doing something after the fact isn't learning. They don't have any ability to think. They're like a candle wick that you just hold a flame over because it's not a person. So you just point it out and put it on the tip of their brain. You didn't say a joke. You are a joke. Think about it. Yeah. And I put a I there because YouTube AI blocks out if you call someone a loser or a joke. Think about it. You're desperate to fit in and have anger in you and no goals. Fitting in isn't a goal. After someone accepts you, after you misrepresent yourself to even get that, you're still empty. Think about it. And then you add some more stuff. You still haven't answered why you think making me wrong scratches that itch in your head, which is very subliminal. You're a weak thing sidestepping through life. And then he responded back. They say he have no idea what I'm talking about, which is, and then he goes back to that same thing, because they're gonna keep trying to do. It's like a rat trying to go in the same hole over and over again. So I just responded to it. Where again, you can see how quickly it responded. While I make this video, it's trying to formulate what angle it can take to make me wrong to feel right. Where that's a Yeah, that's something where they're going to just exhaust, because that's the last thing they have in life before they go off their self. It's the last thing, which doesn't even lead to anywhere. It's just like, that's basically like pissing in the wind when you think about it. It doesn't even lead to anywhere. It's like those two ducktails don't connect. That input doesn't go into that plug. We're making me wrong. It's going to make you all right. It's just a trick where you're just getting closer and closer to offing yourself because you got terminal depression. Because they are dumbest. They are some dumb MFers. It's funny as it is funny. But then I also like this site. It's a site called Whisper. Whisper is a fun site. It's a very fun site. Whisper is a very fun site. Of course, there's a lot of bots on there. But there's a lot of bots on there who I guess can get some simps. It's kind of like sales. Like, if motherfuckers, if you fill out that you need health insurance by mistake on the internet, and then 500 motherfuckers call you because it just goes to the lead site. I guess that's what those bots are doing. They one motherfucker somewhere may be able to, out of the thousands of leads of folks accidentally doing that. One motherfucker somewhere, maybe the first motherfucker who calls, one motherfucker may get a lead. I think that's how those porn bots work. It's like if you're that stupid, it has to be a very low percentage. It has to be a very low percentage. But somehow bots have taken over, which is a microcosm of society. It always happens like that. It's like, yeah, you can think of it like as following trends. Because soulless humans are bots or drones, like a bee is a drone. They're just DNA-based drones where they all do the same thing, faced with the same situation. There's no uniqueness there. So they're just drones. But then when you go into like apps that aren't moderated that well or don't have technology, they're always taken over by fucking bots. And that's what's happening here. They're just taken over by bots. But then it's also a lot of motherfuckers who try to fucking whisper shit too. So here are some of my whispers I have. I have 73 in total. Christian, Jesus freaks, Catholic, Mormons, I should have put JWs, Jehovah Witnesses. All you losers are misusing God and religion. Forget that those... Wait a minute, I could have typed this. Well, no, I can't. It's a limited space. All you losers misusing God and religion, forget that those who don't make mistakes are the ones who are favored. Your selfishness and weakness made Yonder think that. I really wanted to say Yonder thought that shit, monkey, but they don't give you enough space. These broken individuals think that blaming you is the same as personal growth. Then they cheat confidence because of craziness, to not count their mistakes. That's the only reason they have confidence to talk to us. Which is true. And then that kind of relates to this. This is a Christian version of that, to just tear down that lie in her head. So, basically, and then what else is related kind of to that? Toxic individuals make everything wrong because they have doo-doo hands. Like, that's someone who goes to church and they're messed up and they think the church is going to make them better. But then they just bring negativity to the church because they're a turd. Or it's someone who becomes a police officer and they're stupid and doing it for ego. And then they mess up and shoot a citizen. Or it's someone who becomes a doctor and they're not that smart. They can't keep up with medicine after they get their degree. And they have missed opportunities and hurt patients. Basically, that means you have magic doo-doo hands. Whoa, look at that. There's a microcosm of terminal depression. Here's what happens after terminal depression. The soulless monkey has a broke brain. I can't formulate thoughts logically anymore. And the reason for that is a very simple thing. You just tear down the fucking lies in her head. You know, Freddie Mercury... Freddie Mercury left something for your mother, for people out there who are confused as shit. I already know the shit, but and then I guess I could teach what he's saying in a lap of the gods revisit it. I type Freddie Mercury. I guess that was a little band he had or whatever. So it's not gonna show up. I guess he typed a little band he had and shit. But in this song, and A Lap of the Gods Revisited. Of course, he's singing it. He's doing everything that you're supposed to do as a person in A Lap of the Gods Revisited. He's showing you how to do everything you're supposed to do. Basically, you talk in their language because, like I say, they can't think. They're like a candle wick that can't take the flame. They don't have their own thoughts. They're only doing things after the fact. After they hear something, and then the brain works. But then it's a complex brain, so it can almost look like they're sentient, but they're not. So you gotta talk. So it's like they do it in the middle of Bohemian Rhapsody, where it's like Thunderbolts and Lightning, very, very frightening me, but they're saying it to them, so they can program their brain. You know, you talk as them, or you say, if I was as worthless as you, I would jump off a bridge or something. And then what that does, that puts an answer in their brain. Even if they know you're doing it, they can't stop it. It puts an answer in their brain, because they're like a loser who would fail a fill-in-the-blank test. But they would be able to maybe get a 30 on a multiple choice test, which is what they're doing in life. And where others give them answers. The formula is it has to be a logical answer. It has to be something that's firm logical. So you just can't say, it beat yourself with the shoe. And then you can go off yourself. It has to be something that passes the brain's logic process and center. But which is not easy. You have to be smart to do it. That's why it's so amazing. I can just do it endlessly and just make their brain mush to where they can't even formulate thoughts or be able to look at themselves and their actions. And just basically destroy every relationship around them because they're so desperate to scratch an itch to get back dominance. And then it just causes a whole mess while inside it's eating them up. It's just funny. It's just hilarious as fuck. When something doesn't have a soul and is trying to play catch up after the stuff that I say. I have a special way with words. It's not soulless things think that everything they see is on a level of them. Like they used to show in cartoons where the animal would think the first thing it saw was its mommy or was it or was like it. That's its identity because they don't have a self identity. It was like, that's the dumbest thing you could do if you ever run into me. That's the dumbest thing. That's the dumbest thing you can do. You're gonna be an N over your head permanently with no way to fix it, where no therapy or pills can fix it, no hug from your parents or support system can fix it. It's gonna be the worst thing you could ever do. And it's not Freddie Mercury's teaching people. First of all, he's singing as a soulless beast, where it's so easy to be good as a parentheses, but they just can't do it. It's so risky to be evil, but they got to chance it. And it's so funny because something that silly is causing all the pain and trauma that people go to and frustration. But it's so funny because it's so easy for someone to be good. It's so easy to avoid wrong, but they just can't do it, so that's funny. But then it's nothing to laugh about because it causes all the problems. And then kind of like in the other version of this song for people, in A Lap of the Gods, the first one, where it's just about a person and their love of God and on a higher level and being above themselves. And the first in A Lap of the Gods, he ends it with a worldly scenario, where it's like someone, I don't know, maybe it could be a same sex couple, maybe it could be a normal couple or whatever. Who cares? But since they, you know, he touches lips with, he could touch his lips with yours, but in the end, he leave it to the Lord. He leave it to the Lord's, meaning just because he may be with you now, if you're not right with God, you should be able to drop any motherfucker. So he ends it with a worldly scenario, and he ends the other one with a worldly scenario. Where he's talking about his manager, Norman Sheffield, where it's like, my money, that's all you want to talk about. Because all the money that they're making, this idiot thought it was his money. And they just wanted to be famous. So that's a whole nother thing. That's a whole nother subliminal shot going on. with this song and with Bohemian Rhapsody and with Death on Two Legs. Yeah, it's a lot of subliminal shots, but it's so true. It fits on a universal level. So now I'm going to play the song because it's really going to sweat. So now he's using his angelic skills to basically troll this guy. Oh, he's just fucking with Norman Sheffield. What? This is the best line. But I Got a Chance is the best line ever sung. It sounds like auto-tune. It sounds like auto-tune. Whoa, yeah. Now that's a guy who has some vocal talent before he started smoking cigarettes and partying too much. Yeah. Where he said he wanted something for his hands to do at the gay club. If you need something for your hands to do at a gay club, you probably shouldn't be at a gay club. That's my good advice. The whole concept is making fun of solo stuff, where they always say they're no fool, and they think their words override their actions. But if you need someone else to show you what you want to be, like if you need someone else to tell you what your identity is, that means you're not a person. Like this is basically Freddie Mercury making fun of the stupid song Que Sera Sera, where the soulless kid is asking his mom, what would it be when it grows up? Which I'm gonna go back. He has a version of this song called Fuck Off and Die, You Fag. Where he just tells you that's where, isn't that what a mother would say? Is that what you would say if your kid asked you that? Fuck off and die, you fag. Yeah. If they ask you what they want to be when they grow up, wouldn't you just say fuck off and die, you fag? Yeah. I mean, wouldn't you just say that? It's not a version of Que Sera Sera. It's not even a version. I guess someone posted some personal fucking videos and shit to get views or something. We'll see. That kid at school. That's so fucking strange.
Yeah, I think
would you say? Will I be handsome? Will I be rich? Fuck off and die, you fag. Which is true.
If I'm the mother, I'd have to help. Is that the version you were thinking of?
Fuck off and die, you fag. Yes, that's
the one. Fuck off and die, you fag. No slag as well.
Fuck off and die, you slag. Yeah.
Slag. Slag is best. Slag, and you can.
This is a very important part of history. He even say he does a version of this song.
Which was...
Like, when you say he does a version of this song, he's talking about Inner Life of the Gods Revisited. Because he's making fun of soulless fucks and how they have to copy everything. Like, even words. They don't even have their own words. And they apply new meaning to words they hear, kind of like a parrot or something. So it's basically Que Sera Sera. But it's making fun of them. They need you to show them what to be. And then they would say they're no fool. So he's basically roasting soulless fucks. Where it's not even an original tune, it's just Que Sera Sera. It's slightly modified. It's a brilliant song. Of course, it's the same theme as Bohemian Rhapsody. So in Bohemian Rhapsody, he gives an overview. So at the beginning, so no one can get it wrong. And then someone still can't understand it. And whoever was doing this translation, it was a soulless fuck who got triggered, where the translation isn't even accurate. Like whatever parasite who worked for Queen was tasked with typing this. It's like hearing those lyrics, and then they probably just listen to the melody or something, or the tone of his voice, and then when they start listening to the lyrics, it just fucked their brain up. Or you can look as that they don't even type the shit. So. This is a whole experience of hilarious. If you watch this video. I can't see what you want me to be. But I'm no fool. No, that means you are a fool. If you need someone else to define yourself, that's what he's saying. That means you are a fool. Their brain is just mush after hearing this song. Yeah. Well, he's talking about infinity. It's basically the same a-hole as Bohemian Rhapsody. Because all those things are just an a-hole. You never encourage him. That's what he's saying next. Because they can't do it. Keep telling themselves they're not a fool. Dude, that's a lie in their head that they're telling themselves. And then you tear it down. They even show you how to tear it down subliminally in a very occult-like way. Where they say, I'm no fool. And at the extra, I'm going to call it an extra at the end of the song. Or the outro. Like basically an outro chorus that they just repeat. It's basically an interplay with them saying, I'm no fool. And then only one time you have to say that's not true. And then you've torn it down in their brain. You don't have to say it again. I just point out, like I talk about, I just point out numerous stuff that just makes their brain total mush. Or it just overwhelms their brain and changes their whole personality and everything. You don't have to do that. For each single thing, you only have to say it once. And once you say it once, they get heavily emotional and start basically internally arguing with themselves, but it seeps out. Where they try to take it out on the last voice they heard and try to make it true with emotion instead of logic. And basically, he poetically put that in his way through all of it. The way I can explain it literally, he puts it poetically. So the next song is going to be That's Not True. And then it's going to be That I'm No Fool with More Emotion. And then it's going to be Blank. Where it's purposely blank. And then it's gotta be, I'm no fool with more emotion, and then yeah, they just blow up. It's a very brilliant interplay to just show people how to get them the trigger to go off themselves. The end of the song. The last 2 minutes of the song is basically an angelic message to people to get idiots how to go off themselves. So you only have to say that's not true once after they say they're no fool. That's a lie. You only have to turn on that line once and then it's going to internally create an issue inside of them. I just kind of totally missed. I listened to a record voice of the song. And now you're going to listen, he's going to sing, I'm No Fool with More Emotion. And then the next one's going to be purposely blank. Because you don't have to say it again. Like you tore down in the blank. They're just basically being destroyed and eaten up alive. And that's all the anger and self-destruction is. And heavy emotion. He's not a person. It's really that simple. And then it gets really heavily emotional. and then it just blow up. Yeah. They keep having to tell themselves they're not a fool, even though now they're conscious of their own fear. That's basically what you're doing. You turn down the lie with the truth, and then the conscience that God put there is going to take over, and it's going to make them blow up. Because it's not a person. And you can tell they're already in that phase because they would mindlessly deny stuff without explaining it, thinking that they're protecting themselves. That's even how they know it. Because right now, it's basically the first animal that where the door can creep open into logic, where they can click, where they've barely got their toe in the door. But then you can finish it and get them to go off themselves. Because the first animal that can understand its limitation. You can never explain to a gorilla how stupid it is. It would just pound you and destroy you. It doesn't matter how much talking, how much trying to explain to a gorilla how stupid it is. It doesn't have a brain. Its brain is closed off from real logic. It doesn't matter about Coco the gorilla pointing at pictures so it can get free food because it thinks you want it to do it. That's not real logic. If with a human being, the generic human being has a door cracked open for logic. So the animal is defeated. Because it's only going to get better from here as evolution goes on. The animal is already defeated. So you can get them to realize that their limitations are permanent. You can keep focusing on their own logic. A lot of them have a lie in their head that they need torn down, where they think logic doesn't matter all the time, so they can fit in. That's a perfect example to show how they need a lie in their head. They just need a lie in their head, and that's the only reason they keep living and it's barely hanging out. So once you tear down that lie, and again, it's torn down once the brain is confronted with it. Their brain hasn't been confronted with it fully in a right way, if they're going with it, because their conscience overrides that. And once that's done, it would just make them stink. It would stink. It would feel almost like burning. It would feel almost like just something being torn down where they can keep doing it, but they're just hurting themselves. And then they're going to get even more emotional and more desperate. And since they're soulless, they can't do anything more. They have to squat on what they have. So once you tear down that lie and just tear down many lies, their whole personality changed because they don't have the energy to keep the facade up, and it just crumbles. It just crumbles. And it's God's way of pulling them, of thinking they're a little kid, because spiritually they are, because they don't have a soul. They're just baby tones. It's like pulling a kid by the ear and making them go and apologize to everyone that they wronged. Everyone that they wronged is everyone who they misrepresented themselves and tricked into being their friend. So basically, at this point, they can't keep up a facade anymore. So that's like pulling them in the air and showing everyone who they wronged the real them. So they can be tested to go to heaven or hell. Just showing them the real them. And also, so by the time they kill themselves, no one real is going to care. Even if they misguidedly try to be nice to their family, no one real is going to care, basically. Basically. That's how simple it is. So they're thinking they're doing something by living longer, but they're just showing everyone them in their toxic form. And they're also thinking they're going to get back to normal. They just have to do one more thing, and then they're going to get back to normal, which is never going to happen. That's just a trick in their brain to make them show everyone how toxic they are. Oh, but then it's such a clusterfuck for them because they have to follow urges since they don't have a soul to think. Their whole life they had to follow urges. But now their urges are so messed up, they can't even trust their urges. And they don't have a soul to put together logic, so it's just a total mess where they eventually lose everyone they thought they had because they're toxic and can't control themselves. They don't even fully understand it. They're just thinking they're being themselves, and they thinking that all their friends and support system loves them unconditionally, which isn't true, or they wouldn't need a facade. Think about it. Basically, when they're about to kill themselves, basically nothing is happening. It's like they're pushing others away. They have pain inside of them. They can't really articulate, and they cover it up by trying to come on strong and shit. And that just pushes others away further. It's just a total hell. That's why I'm an angel of mercy. I tell them, you should probably just do it as soon as possible. It's not going to get better. Then they get mad at me. I'm telling you the truth. There's no way to fix it. You should probably just go off and do that as soon as possible. Because your brain isn't going to feel good gambling. Right now, you're saying you don't even know how you're going to get better. So you're saying if you gamble or get something you didn't earn fully, that you're okay with that. No person is okay with that. That's already waiting in your brain. Once your brain knows that no person, no real person would be happy with something they didn't earn, and you would be happy with something you didn't earn, your brain already knows that means you're not a person. It's going to hit that stress button. It's going to hit the insecurity button. There's no way to fix it. I'm giving you the best advice when I tell you, have some dignity and go off yourself. Have the dignity of Judas. At least, you don't want to, right now you're worse than Judas. Because anything that has evil in them, a person never has evil or a monster. And you thinking that you just have to hide the monster, that's bad thinking. That's a retarded thought there. You thinking that the solution is you just hide the monster. A person doesn't have the monster. So your brain already knows you're not a person no matter what you say. You won't have logic to top that logic. That's how the brain works. You got to have logic to top the logic that you're reacting to. You just can't do it with anger, or the brain knows that means you're not a person. So it's not going to work. You just got busted. Just have some dignity and stop making it worse.